Robbie here from Arsenal Fan TV. I'm on the social club here at Ball Street, and I wanted to ask the guys, whilst we've got everybody together here, about if Arsene Wenger does leave, and we all know he's under a lot of pressure. He may not. But if he does leave, who they think would be a good replacement? I thought it'd be good. We've got paired at Everton fan, obviously. Paul, Liverpool, you all know Troops. But he will go. One day he will go. Who would be a good replacement for him? Because it's going to be real big shoes to fill. Yeah. No matter what anybody thinks.
It's a big coat to fill, isn't it?
A big coat to fill as well. Yeah. But, you know, 20 years he's been here. He's kept us stable. He's won things for the club as well. Let's not forget that. And he's been super duper consistent. So whoever comes in are going to have really demanding fans. Fans are going to want to see them win things. Fans are going to want to see them progress things. They're probably not going to have like loads and loads of money to spend. So they're going to have to go with the majority of the team that they have at the moment. So they're going to have to come in and really, you know, get those guys up to a level. So who would be the perfect replacement? Who do you think? I'll go with you first.
Well, please. Can I ask you a question of you guys, if there's anything else? Because I think there's two approaches. There's the, you go out, the first one I think is what you should do, is go out there, find the best possible guy for the job. Don't care what job he's in at the moment. Don't care what he costs. You go out there and you say, this is the guy to take us forward. He's a number one target, go and secure him. But the other thing is, look at what Man United had to do. There's a very strong case to be made.
No, we don't want that.
No, you don't want that. But I always felt at the time that Moyes was almost like the rebound. Exactly. But the point is, it was always doomed to failure. So go and get someone who's not mega, he's not a big name, who can be a bit of a patsy while you're going through this transition, because the next guy is going to have all of the Wenger pressure heaped on his shoulders. Moyes lowered the expectations at Man United, and I know they're on the fringes of not getting back to where they want to be, but it meant now, having had a few difficult years, they're now bought into what Mourinho was trying to do, if you get me.
We don't want none of that at Arsenal. I want somebody who's going to be the best person for the job. Right, so who would you say
Diego Simeone for me? I would go out there. If I was Arsenal, I would look and say, the guy plays a good brand of football, but he's a fucking animal as well. And he loves the fight, and that's everything that Arsenal have lacked for 15 years. It's that, slightly less than 15 years, but 13 years. Sorry.
Close enough.
Don't follow his avidly or anything like that. But the point is, we were chatting about this, before, you know, go back to what Arsenal had around the Invincibles era. Look, you're going to struggle. You can never recreate that. That was an incredible moment in time. But what that team had was it had leaders, and it had a real edge to it as well. And I think a lot of that was left over from the 90s and stuff. But yeah, go out and get a guy who makes your players go out there and die for the club and worry about like the good fancy football. You'll have that still at the DNA of your team because Wenger's put that into the club. Get someone who can just add that real bite to the football club. And for me, Simeone is right up there.
Troops.
Simeone.
No, you can't have the same person as him. I want you to be creative now.
All right.
Be creative. Allegri. Why? Allegri. Give us a case.
Allegri's a winner. He's about to win his third Scudetto in a row. When he was at Milan, he brought them back up because they were flopping at the time. He brought them back up. Mm-hmm. He's rated more in Italy than Conte. I think he's won 38 home games in a row. He's a leader. He's not afraid to drop people.
We saw the thing with Benucci the other day. Big Champions League
away game. Porto's a difficult place to go. He dropped his best defender and still kept a clean sheet and still won the game. It shows you that he has balls. And I love the way he is on the touchline. He's a madman, and that's what I want. I want a man who instills passion into the team because the passion's been sucked out of it. And we need to get passion back in the team. And we all know the Italians are very passionate people as well. And if he came, maybe he could bring Dybala with him, maybe.
You're getting greedy now.
Me, come on, man. My eye bigger than my belly right now, you know. Trust me.
Pitt.
I'd go for Thomas Tuchel from Dortmund.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, he's stole probably the best two. But I think maybe slightly someone who's up and coming who could be the next big one. And that's, I think...
Is that a trap that Arsenal could fall into, though? Because I guarantee Eddie Howe gets linked.
Yeah,
with
of course
job.
He will.
Guaranteed.
Yeah.
But I can't think of a bigger poison chalice for him to step into as his first.
Yeah, but you're talking about Dortmund, you're talking about Bournemouth, they. So my massive club in Germany.
Plays a good style
of
football.
He's got a good style of football. Gets on really well with his players. Speaks perfect English as well. That's not a problem. Seems to be one of the modern kind of man, almost in the style of Pep Guardiola, rather than sort of a German manager. Rather than, he's like a mix of Pep Guardiola and Klopp, I think. I think that could suit that. I think that could suit the Arsenal because he's quite. I don't think he's sort of. He's got that sort of conservative style. The Arsenal. When I say conservative, you know what I mean. He's like he's got the look of a good modern manager as well. But he's got the rest of it to back him up. And I think he's going to be the next big one. But you're right. You don't necessarily want the next big one. You want the big one.
He's not actually won anything either, has he?
No, he hasn't. But I think the job he's.
But he's proved that he can come in. And fill big shoes because he's coming after Klopp. So
definitely. Mm. So again, it's slightly different for what yous want, but I think he could be the next big one. And it might be a case of yous might need a manager this year. It might be next season, and maybe next season it'll be his first big season in Germany while he's been getting his feet under the
table.
We
learned the lesson with Brendan Rodgers about the up and coming thing. I still think Rodgers is a terrific manager, and I don't think you can use the Celtic thing to prove or disprove anything because it's you win that league by default as Celtic manager, don't you? But he was an up-and-coming manager. The problem we had was he learned on the job, and it's very hard to put up with guys making obvious mistakes and having to go through these things. Now, we were bought into it at the time, but I do think Arsenal need to, because the problems with Arsene Wenger is you're not winning stuff at the top end, that it's going to be very hard because of the way your fan base has gone over the last few years. I think you'll back the new manager, but I don't think that a new manager's not going to get 13 years with a couple of FA Cups.
No manager's ever going to get that sort of period again. And also, I think you have to take into account when you talk about that 13-year period that. I don't blame Wenger for about 8 years of that
I agree.
You know, we moved to a new stadium. He virtually had no budget and he just had to work with what he had. It's really been the last few years where you look at it and say, well, oh, come on. Now you can't blame the stadium stuff and that anymore.
Who do I want? You want, what's his name? The Chili Brother.
I'm going to go Sam Parley.
Yeah.
Right? I like that guy, man. Manager of Sevilla. Yeah, he has been linked with Barca. Probably will end up at Barca. Yeah. But I like that guy. This style of football would be perfect for Arsenal. He plays that similar style of like Klopp pressing game. He's a real tactician as well, though. Yeah. He just doesn't have one way of playing. And, you know, look what he's done with Chile. Back-to-back Copa Americas.
Make Alexis stay.
He could have a chat with Alexis and say stay. You know what I mean? I really like it. There's some, you know what this shows though, that there's some good candidates out
available.
There. And let's not forget when people like some people have said to me, yeah, but why would some of these managers come to Arsenal? Well, basically, I'll give you one good reason. All of those managers that we've just spoken about would double their wages, probably.
Exactly. Yeah.
Because Arsene Wenger's like on 8.5 million a year.
8.9.
One of the highest paid managers in the world. So, if he says to Allegri, if he says to Sampaoli. None of those guys are nowhere near those wages.
What about Emery?
Umar.
Yes,
he's a good
shot. That's
who
I wanted to take over Everton.
He's very weak.
I was probably reaching, but...
Can I throw an outside shout in? I don't want to mention Rafa.
No, sure. Nah. Not bad.
Nah.
Funnily enough, I actually don't think, from what you took, what I know you guys want, but he seems to end up in these jobs over and over again. And he is a very, very good manager. And
he is a good manager.
He could, you know, he's the kind of guy who could take your squad and deliver a European Cup or have a very good fist of a European competition. I just don't know whether he would be.
But I think I think as well, whoever comes in next is going to have to be someone who's going to unite the fan base. Straight away, people be like, nah, not Rafa Benitez. You know, I think it's got to be a fresh. All the names that you guys have suggested, I think people would get behind.
Yeah,
that's what I think.
No free Lonsdale today.
Anybody else in the
front? I think those two.
Give me one more name.
Whoever takes over, the first challenge is obviously going to have to be closing the gap between you and Tottenham, isn't it? So.
Well, hang on a second. You mentioned one.
All right, I've got one to throw in.
Who's the?
I've got one to throw in. Luis Enrique.
Luis Enrique. Mm.
He's available.
He's got all the hallmarks of what you guys will actually do. You'll go and get Enrique. Like someone's gone, oh, he was manager of Barcelona, wasn't he? And you go, oh, yeah, great. And then
give him an 8-year contract.
Give him an 8-year contract. Yeah. You know, that.
But you know what? People talk down about that guy. Look what he's won.
Exactly. Look what he's
achieved. And let's remember, right? Barcelona coming in after Pep Guardiola as well.
It's a big challenge.
Big shoes to fill.
It was a wild
pressure job. They don't accept nothing apart from, winning. it might not be a bad shout.
No, I think
he did win the Champions League his first season.
He did. Yeah.
It was his first season winning.
But I think he was almost like a prototype that they just dropped in, which that's what they're doing at Barcelona, isn't it? They're just everything's there and they're just dropping them in. I don't think
that's why I'm worried about your boy Koeman. Because he's a Barca product.
No, I don't think I think.
Yeah, he could be a Barca next season.
I honestly don't think they
actually,
go.
Actually, you might be doing this next.
If you were, all right, well, let me
before
just...
Before the end of the season, right. You may be hosting this programme.
Right, let me just ask you this. Who's the seventh best team in Spain at the moment?
The seventh?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Now, do you want their manager? Exactly.
Who is their manager?
I don't know. I don't know who the seventh best team is.
One
but that's the point, isn't right, it? If there was an Arsenal legend managing the seventh best team in Spain, would you want him to be your manager?
No, that's a good point.
No, but I'm not with this legend thing taking.
No, that's what I'm saying, and that's why I don't think they'll take Koeman. It's because he manages Everton and we're seventh in the Premier League. If I was a Barca fan, I'd be like, nah. I'd be on the same list we're talking about here.
But then I suppose you do also have to look and say to yourself, what could he do with better players?
Oh, I'm no thing that if he comes, he will be the Barca manager. I just don't think they'll be looking at Ronald Koeman. I just don't think he's a good enough manager at this stage. Okay. I think they'll be
One last one, sorry. Something you mentioned. There's a certain dynamic duo going on at the international level with Belgium that might be circling around.
Thierry Henry and Mr. Martinez. I mean, he smells fucking boss. If that's any.
Thierry Henry is a number two. I wouldn't mind. Yeah. Martinez.
The dream is Allegri with Vieira as number two. That's my dream.
Vieira as well.
And then like you put Bergkamp on the board.
I was going to say, Henry and Bergkamp.
You bring in Adams.
I mean, he couldn't fly anywhere, but...
What do you guys think? Leave it in the comments below. Don't forget as well to get over to Ball Street. Check out all of their videos from the social club. You know, leave your comments. Who would make a good manager to replace Arsene Wenger?
Ty.